mate. They don't have to do it on the map. Maybe that should be description. Yeah. Or maybe we tag it with that. So hard to forget my, I shouldn't use my right hand this time. This time. My left hand, yeah, so all I'm starting here. So putting my left hand on there. Just to hook onto the side, that's the last thing I might just use. This is a sign of capital ring. They're like, try to find it. Middle Eastern. Yeah. So they're getting some work done to it. Is it still a functioning pumping station? General infrastructure. Oh, you know what? It's probably access to the sewers, right?
Oh, yeah.
It's probably above.
Yep.
Yeah, so it's probably what it's used for. There's all kinds of like crazy bits of public infrastructure, like pumping stations and like railway electrical termination boxes and stuff like that. And they just, even though they're like out in the sticks, I guess like I've actually, when we label the video, I think we should also label the name of the walk. And it'd be nice if we kept a checklist ourselves of like, yeah, and then maybe build up a checklist of like the different routes to do. I do like seeing the transition of the city as well. Like how it kind of goes into quite quiet residential areas and you get into shops and stuff. And it dies down again. It's like there's like a flow to the city. And it's all in this form. That's quite cool, isn't it?
Yeah.
I think the picture's really helpful. Yeah. Because, like, yeah, looking on the map's really, really good. And the map is useful. I mean, it's good that they've got the map button there, actually. It's kind of place itself. Yeah. because of like, the way the camera's pointed most of the time in this like, spot shape, I think maybe it might make sense to stay on the right side of the road. Yeah. Check on the map. Oh look, the sign. Cross over. Hang on. There must be so many of those around the country though, isn't there? I mean, these are like ancient buildings that have been around for a while. Yeah. Yeah. It's coffee, isn't it? I wonder if they know, like, there's a lot of hikers in this. Yeah, I wouldn't go out here. Thank you. quite crafty one. And there, they've got extremely strict rental laws. And so essentially, like, everything is in favour of the renters instead of the landlords. And yes, and so, like, they've got things like landlords have to give you a huge amount of notice. Something ridiculous, like 6 months or something. I think it's something. But anyway, there's like a lot of laws that make it basically make renting very, very secure. Like, okay, nice. Well, remember, this branches off into lots of different groups, right? So, and so like everything is really sort of in the renter's favour, so that you don't get messed around, right? Like, you know, you're not going to get your deposit, you're not going to get screwed over on your deposit and stuff like that. You know, you're not going to have stuff deducted. The landlords have to respond in a timely manner, otherwise they get really insane fines. So they've got like really strict standards on like that landlords have to meet and all that kind of stuff. It is impressive, but here's the thing. Whenever you ask people from Scandinavian countries, do you want a property? Or do you want to own property? They're like, no, why? Renting's fine. You know? You know, there's so much, like, it's a lot of work to actually maintain a property.
Yeah, like you can
yeah. Well, I mean, I'm going to even say this, yeah? I'm going to say that the reason properties in the UK, or landlords in the UK, are so shit, especially in London, is because I think there has been this drive towards everyone should own a home. Everyone should own a home. That should be, like, the way you make a rental income. You just have a house, and you rent it out. And a lot of the time, these landlords, they're just, like, normal people. And they're not... You know, they're not cut out to do all of that stuff. So, like, when they do have to do things like maintenance and repairs, it is actually, like, a lot of work for them, right? So you can see, like, why the standards aren't as high. But then if they just made the barrier to, like, owning a property, right, and renting it out much higher, then, then that way, like, properties would be better overall for living. People would be more inclined to rent them and not want to buy them. And the ones that are on the market are actually well looked after.
Yeah. I think you're right. I
guess the difficult thing, I guess this is like part of the reason why politically it's a massive vote loser. It doesn't matter like what part side of the political spectrum it's on, not left or right wing. But in general, you don't want to screw over homeowners, because, you know, they've invested a lot of money to get the mortgage out and stuff like that, and then if you suddenly devalue their property, right, then they've just, like, lost all of that investment. Yeah. Going quite through the park, aren't we?
Yeah, because we came to the park.
It's amazing, I didn't realise that was all time post. Yeah. Yeah. A Lido, similar to the hill. That as well, you know, and also something that we could do together,
yeah,
that we both enjoy.
Yeah.
And I guess this kind of like combines a bit of everything. One, isn't it? I love it though. This is the perfect weather. Actually, to be honest, there was a bit of rain. I like doing it as a class. Socially distanced. Yeah. And I guess it's a bit more pricey. I do really want to do the yoga. I feel like my back and stuff is really... I really do want to go to a physio. So I've got like a few problems with that. some of the sun. A little bit pain. Yeah. And I mean, you know what? Stuff like this, if they wanted to have a quick fix, encourage people to start walking and do more exercise, which is more social distance in this way. Encourage people to do this type of stuff. I mean, look around here. Like this crossroad. Yeah, but then it's not that. But that's the thing, if they wanted to just encourage people to do it, all they have to do is just like that. Print off a new type. Well, I think TfL is, they put a lot of resources into it, but I think the problem is because TfL is so massive and it covers so many areas. You go onto the website, it's just surrounded by noise, right? I mean, it's competing for other, the intention of other things, right? Like, you know, TfL walking tours, right? And all of these. So I think that's it's just all there. They're still maintaining it. It's all on the because now, like, look, Google knows we're going to do this. It knows we're here, it knows we're up, right? It knows that we've previously searched for that camera on YouTube, right? So it's like, so these guys have got to walk and film their stuff, eh? Well, I guess we'll shove them more ads around this and we'll, like, tailor the video for this. They know. So, I don't know, you're the man. Yeah. Yeah. really nice, and then my friend was like, oh, it's okay, I'll run alongside you whilst you're training. And then that person just feels super awkward and is like, yeah, really nice. And then I can't actually do my training. Yeah. So, I guess it's okay, isn't it? That seems more likely. Less how's the route looking? Is it like straight here? We have to put some payment details down, I guess. There's no booking fee that we have to pay. I mean, the problem is though, I kind of want to let them know. I think maybe that's wrong. think I've tried to do different issues. Mostly okay. I think the problem that I had was I wasn't used to like the flow of it. So I wasn't sure like, oh, was it gonna ask me like who to send it to, blah blah blah, all that kind of stuff. Like I wasn't quite sure the steps. So it was a bit confusing at first. I think if I did it enough times, I thought it seems confusing. Like do around the front or around the back? Yeah, ideally around the back. Right? Yeah. How often is that? Yeah, yeah, very nice, very comfortable. I can't believe it's just walked inside, isn't it? Well, I mean, I didn't want to, I was kind of taking the piss out of it. Now.
So now. Because if I call it a sandal,
I'll have to go to all the different types of sandals. This is how it happens, isn't it? This is how it happens.
This
is like so swingy, swingy.
Very swingy.
Like, it's like a perfect pendulum, isn't it? Good pendulum. I don't know about you. Have you been getting more stairs? Yeah. Like looking at the cat.
Oh, have
you? I think it's been like what was when we went into that passage thing? That was like over the railway. And another one was a pendulum lady. Maybe they're just I think that's it. I think they're kind of like trying to suss me out. They're like, is this guy a weirdo? Like, yeah, he is a bit of a weirdo actually. But yeah, like, oh yeah, but there's a lady, so you can't be too weird. Yeah. Do you want a bike?
Huh?
Bike. I want to think. Yeah, no, you know what? I'm actually up for spoons. I've still got the app on my phone. I mean, here's the thing with food. They don't care what you look like. You can go in there wearing this, right? It's fine. They don't care. It's for everybody. So, we could just go to one that's new. Yeah? Because they're everywhere. Well, I mean, here's the thing, is like, we could even be sitting in the club and there's no rush, right? It is that tempting, though. And did you try calling back that number, what they called you? Oh, is that what they're calling now? See, I wonder if you call another branch. Maybe they've got access to the same system. Well, maybe you can just start them and say, I'm trying to get through to your garage, but I can't. So I'm doing you. Well, this is on. No, this is on. Actually, no. Alum Leisure Centre. Right here. I'm actually very glad I didn't come out in June. I think I've learned. No, you know what? I've learned my lesson now. When you're doing this kind of thing, you just have to be practical. Yeah. No, exactly. Yeah. I think like I've been trying to, the other thing as well that I want to do this holiday. Was it around here? Oh man, how long did it take you to get here? One bus, okay. How long was the bus ride? 30 minutes. Yeah. Okay, yeah. Beautiful, like Art Deco style. I love the signage. Yeah. And oh, look at that balcony. Really nice. Kind of reminds me of Mullenhof a little bit. I mean, look, for a long time though, it's kind of full for choice in London, isn't it? And I think also, like, because Because everything was so expensive. Because everything was so expensive, we kind of felt like they were like a risk or something that I don't know is going to be good. You know? Take a safe bet, yeah. Not wrong, eh? I'm very good at it. Why? From what? How are we doing on the route? How many steps are we? Okay. I'm guessing then those must be the showers. Yes, the bathrooms. If some of them are from toothbrushes. Oh wow, my eggs. Yes. Probably get like a coat rack and stuff in there, shoe rack and all that business. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. starts to go left, which is down, right? That's not the alleyway. Check on the map. Actually, it wasn't the capital ring. In fact, that was the one that goes all the way to the left. Okay. Yeah. We'll get to see the old flat, yeah. And we know we're very well acquainted with the weather screen.
Well,
more than
one second.
Yeah. Well, not struggled with money. Money's always been tight. Yeah. And so I guess we just ended up learning to be more frugal, right? And I think, like, yeah, we ended up learning to be more frugal. And I think, like, that behavior just kind of switched. Because you suddenly, you just have less of a desire for like material things. Well, also I think another part of it is because people work like big media, big advertising, all that kind of stuff. We kind of like our brand is just fucking bullshit. And they're just this advertising construct. Tells you something important, and so you believe it's important, right? Yeah. Alleyway, there you go. Very good directions. Yeah, it's hard to finish that for that wheel. where do we end up at the entrance? What's the destination? You're going to have to help me. We're gonna have to like investigate the whole video CEO scene, right? SEO scene.
SEO.
SEO scene.
Yeah.
Because we're gonna have to like name this the right way and tag it the right way. Yeah. You found that stuff as well, yeah. I think you must do. Hey, I mean, like, if they're renting it from the train station. Could be. Splitting the cost, but then also the train station gets a bit money as well, wouldn't it? You know? Nice to get a breather. I see that one, yeah.
I think that's what takes that one.
Okay. Up to you. Your fault. You're going to have to get like a board across that. We're going to have to trim off the beginning, right? So like the boundaries and stuff like that. Then I'll probably also... that I don't know yet. Maybe we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. Yeah. I want to get it up online. Actually, I was going to say... Yeah. Actually, I was going to say... Do you think... I don't know if we're going anywhere. Yep, sounds good to me. Yeah, could do that. I mean, we are. Yeah, actually, it's fine because. No, it's fine because, like, I was thinking, oh, yeah, but we've got to go to work on Thursday. Nah, but work is at home. So, just chilling out, yeah. 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 Just relax, yeah. Yeah, I think so. Yeah, so maybe tomorrow is when we do all of our editing, uploading, finding. Yeah, we could do the charity shop, yeah. So, I was going to say, like, that's kind of my aim for this holiday. Is I kind of wanted to be a bit of a reset in terms of like my routine and stuff. Like I really want to get back into early nights, you know, and kind of keep it consistent. I think, yeah, early morning solo sessions, but then also back on the weekends. I kind of want to move away from like, okay, then Friday night comes in and I just stay up till like 4 a.m. and just get, you know, whatever, and then. Like wake up late on Saturday morning and then just do the same thing on Saturday night. You know? I kind of want to, you know, really maximise the time and just get back into, I don't know, just more sort of productive space. Thank you. hoping that this thing that comes out. Oh yeah, the limit starts on the internet. Just mark that one. We'll help. Yeah. I think eventually, once we get good at these walks, and we've done like a few of these routes over and over again, I was actually going to suggest, what do you think of the idea of just, instead of taking out a normal phone for these walks, just taking a totally dumb phone and being like 100% disconnected? Yeah. I mean, I guess like the only thing I'd probably keep would be maybe like a podcast app or something like that. But the music and that's it. Yeah. I don't know. That's maybe the way to go. Yeah, fantastic. Nice. Oh, what a wonderful spot this is. You had that all to yourself. Oh. Yeah. Like a fluffy pillow. Is this where we're about to go anyway? Just everywhere. frequent. Yes, it's very easy to see. I was wondering, like, what's the point of this? This thing that's on the floor. And at first I thought, oh, it's a mistake, right? Like a shot or something like that. Part of it is, no, it's deliberate for the cyclists to know what's on the floor. Yeah. Well, no, I'm not going to buy we have to walk alongside the golf course. Well, I wonder how much of our voice comes through, how much of our voice is background into it. Depends on what we talk about. We'll come across the world. guess the other thing it's considering is like carrying a lot of weight. Big upset because they said, well, that looks like a prison. There'd be a high security presence. I guess if there was a prison break, it would be a bit different, but I'm guessing if there was a prison break, the escapees would probably want to get as far away from the prison as possible. So actually, I think it might be. was. I actually really don't mind being on crossroads and letting a car park go past us, because inevitably you kind of hear the music and you get like a brief glimpse into someone's life. I want to highlight the point. London's massive. Yeah. It's massive and it's pretty diverse. If you don't like one bit of it, just walk like 10 minutes and you'll find another. No, you don't need that. There's only like kind of like anything I've ever seen there. I really wonder how stable it does look like it's bouncing the right bit. I think the opponent is it would be quite cool if there was like a strap along here. So yeah, but yeah, so maybe next time I'll try the Takai and see if that gives me better mounting options. Yeah. Because the clip's pretty versatile. So might be more. Well, what stop are we on? You know what, that would work really well. And on your car. Then it's like just it's on your face, it looks like sunglasses. Yeah. Then you just have to be a bit more wary first. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Well, you can tell because you've got a map. Oh, that's a nice breeze through the toes. I think if we're like getting about 10, you know, under 10 stops away from our destination, then I think I'd just push through and pick up. Yeah, just relax, but if you're feeling tired, you can turn around. Okay. We could do that. I mean, like I said, we're probably going to have to edit this anyway. Sign. We can actually have an intermission here. So we're carrying straight down that way. I know we originally said, oh, we'll just start up there and that's it, done, right? But I'd actually like to put a lot of work into just the tagging and the data on it. So, like, not only have it so that it's tagged correctly and the titles of whatever, but also putting a subtitle track on there. And the subtitle track just having the names of some of the locations that we've got at. Yeah. And then that way, it will kind of help appear in more places, right? Yeah. relatively hot rooms right now, isn't it? So I'm totally beating down on it. Oh wow. Something that people forget about, right? Like, everyone thinks canals, they're like, oh, well, I've got to get like a riverside place right in Camden, right? But they've got the canals all over them. So you can get places that are just along with any canal. See, that will be a really nice route to do. I'd love to do just a walk along the canal. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Yeah, I'm going to have to cut you out a couple of times. Thank you. this, is it? Wimbledon Park Station. I guess you just need to find a pub around Wimbledon. Shouldn't be too hard to find, it's going to be the demographic here. We're quite close though, aren't we? How many more stops? Yeah. Oh, is that what we're getting to? Wicked. We did it. Yeah, man. So